Ronnie takes a dig at Mark Selby at the Saudi Arabia Snooker Championship.
Certain players with an opportunity to beat John Higgins and reach the quarterfinals at the Crucible as a consequence. Six. You would wonder, question, whether they could hold themselves together. Mark Allen most certainly can.
Didn't quite come far enough on this red. He doesn't like it. And I don't blame him, because the red that's closest to the right corner may stop the black going once he makes contact with the black. So, change of plan.
Seven.
I think he may have come too far, or not far enough. The red 11. By the pink spot will go.
Twice.
So if he can finish fairly straight on this next red, that will lead him to the black. What an attacking shot. And that's exactly what he played. Into the red, screw out of them, with a lot 26. Of whiz on that cue ball. And he was guaranteed to be on that red next to the black.
Fifteen years ago, in this round of the 2009 World Championship, Mark Allen defeated Ronnie O'Sullivan. Tonight, is he going to teach another member of the class of 1992 a lesson?
34.
It's in his hands, Phil. Having to go up for the blue. But not 35. A problem, as long as he gets the right side, which he has done. He's got choice of reds now, and John knows this is a good chance for Mark Allen.
And it's been a recurring story for John Higgins. Time and again over the 40. Last 3 years, he's been so close to big victories.
41.
And so often, his hopes have been dashed in a final frame. Are we seeing history repeating itself? You have to believe so.
Well,
he needs to finish it at this visit because Higgins is the king of clearances. Nudged another red out. But those four reds surrounding the pink, relatively safe.
Fifty-seven.
And now a chance to go into those four reds. Is he on one? Fearing the worst, John Higgins. 62. It's too high.
Mark Allen, 62.
Red and the black would have been safe. Is it a double? There's no better doubler, I can tell you. And if it goes in, they're all there. And he'd be getting rid of the bad red as well. He's on the black, and what was I saying earlier about the king of clearances? He's got a chance. Just one tricky red near the cushion. There isn't a better doubler.
There's an old chestnut in sport, in snooker. Form is temporary, class is permanent.
Nine.
All of those years, all of those wins. Can Higgins turn the clock back?
Can he hold himself together?
16.
A long time since I've been this nervous watching a snooker match.
23.
It's magical.
24.
Just overrun slightly. Thank you. must he be feeling? Look at the crowd.
31.
Mesmerised. He's overdone it. He's overdone it. He can't get to the red now. Potted the red on the far knuckle and lost the cue ball. Couldn't get close to the red. Now, does he take it on? Or does he play the snooker? He'll be kicking himself,
39.
Not being the right side of the black. Brilliant. Absolutely brilliant. And perfectly onto the bought colours. And now he knows it's out of his hands. That simple red with the rest.
Joe, we've just seen the epitome of snooker guts. Is it going to lead
44
to glory?
He's short.
46.
Oh, no, he isn't. He's on the green. I beg your pardon.
...49.
He still needs the lot. Come on, John.
And
perfectly onto the blue. There shouldn't be any mistakes from here, but I can tell you his heart will be pumping.
58.
How can you not feel sympathetic for Mark Allen? He's played a terrific frame in many respects.
64.
Shaking on the black, but now it's shake, rattle and roll into the quarterfinals. The wonderful clearance against Ronnie O'Sullivan in the Masters final, and now that one, another in the book of brilliance for John Higgins.
Ronnie takes a dig at Mark Selby at the Saudi Arabia Snooker Championship.